Namaste everyone. This is Sucheta from Goham Yoga. From today till 21st of June 2020, which is the International Day of Yoga, I'm going to try and answer one question daily about yoga that I get asked frequently. Okay, so this is going to be an answer to that question as per my knowledge and my capacity. Okay, so today's question is, what are the different types of yoga and what type should I choose if I have to start practicing yoga, right? So here I'm going to assume that when you ask me about practicing yoga, you are necessarily talking about yoga asanas, that is the posture, that is the practice of yoga that is meant for your physical fitness. And it goes without saying that anyone who starts practicing yoga for physical benefits is bound to get its mental health benefits as well. Okay, so to answer your question very simply, let me tell you at parent level what are the different paths or types of yoga. So we start with Raja Yoga, which is the first type. Then there is Bhakti Yoga, right? Then there is Karma Yoga, and then there is Jnana Yoga. Jnana or Jnana, Jnana, it depends on how you pronounce it. So these are the four main types of yoga, or these are the paths that you can assume to reach the ultimate goal of yoga, right? So this Raja Yoga is something that is told by Patanjali. So we all know about Patanjali Yoga Sutras and the Ashtanga Yoga Marga that Patanjali has talked about. So this is about self-control. Raja Yoga is Patanjali Yoga and it is about self-control. Then Bhakti Yoga, it is about self-surrender. Because as the word itself explains, Bhakti is about devotion. It is about surrendering. Then Karma is about sacrifice, self-sacrifice. And then Jnana is about knowledge, which is self-analysis. Okay, so it is, so you have to prefix self to all this. So it is self-control, self-surrender, self-sacrifice and self-analysis, right? So this is at the concept level, right? So, a person who seeks knowledge all through the life can be called Jnana Yogi, correct? Because that is the path that the person has chosen for himself. A person who thinks that the cause that he or she is working for is greater than he or she himself as a person is a Karma Yogi. And then all the saints that we know, right? They all are devotees. They are all Bhakti Yogis, or they are on the path of Bhakti Yoga. Okay, but in modern times, when we talk about yoga practice and we think about asana, we are only talking about Raja Yoga. So I'm going to wipe these three types of yoga for now, right? So we will only consider Raja Yoga, which is also Patanjali Yoga. And this term Raja Yoga became popular when Swami Vivekananda ji wrote a book about Raja Yoga, right? So now let's think about Raja Yoga. Now from Raja Yoga, there are a lot of other branches, okay, that came from Raja Yoga, okay? So the main are Hatha Yoga. Okay, then there is Kundalini Yoga, right? And then there is Laya Yoga, okay? And then there are so many others, but we do not want to talk about those branches for now, so I'm again going to wipe this off. Okay, there are so many of them, right? But let us now again consider only Hatha Yoga. Okay, so we all need to understand that in modern times, again, when we start practicing asanas, we are necessarily performing Hatha Yoga, which is comparatively modern practice than the Raja Yoga or Patanjali Yoga. Now, but because Hatha Yoga actually started talking about asanas, the postures, because in Patanjali Yoga, Raja Yoga, from 196 sutras, Patanjali has talked about asanas only in two yoga sutras, right? So we do not get much information about the postures or physical aspect of the yoga from Raja Yoga. But Hatha Yoga started talking about postures, right? Because the practitioners of Hatha Yoga, they chose the path of physical fitness or physical postures to go towards the goal of Raja Yoga. The goal is still the same, which is Samadhi, as told by Patanjali. Hatha Yoga, it has the same goal. Okay, so we all practice Hatha Yoga. Let us understand what are the types of Hatha Yoga and the names that we hear in modern times about Hatha Yoga. So what I will do is, I will write this in the center. Okay, so Raja Yoga and then Hatha Yoga. Okay, so from Hatha Yoga, what do we know? The different kinds of Hatha Yoga practices. Iyengar, we all know about this name, BKS Iyengar. Then there is Ashtanga Vinyasa. Okay. Then there is Bikram Yoga. Okay. There is Hot Yoga, not Hatha Yoga. Okay. There is a form called Hot Yoga. Then there is Power Yoga. So these are a few of the popular asana practices that come from Hatha Yoga, right? So main that I have told you. So what are the differences? It is Power Yoga, as the name explains, it's powerful practice. So it has a lot of postures that are weaved into one flow, and you practice that entire flow is Power Yoga. Ashtanga Vinyasa it has a series, like they have a primary series, intermediate, two series, advanced series, and so on. So it is a ready-made practice for you. So if you practice Ashtanga primary series, the complete series, then you will have to practice for about 90 to 95 minutes, and that is a really very very physically challenging series. So that is Ashtanga Vinyasa, is by Sri Pattabhi Joyce of Mysore. Iyengar, BKS Iyengar invented this style of yoga. Then there is Bikram Yoga. Bikram Yoga is, again, it has a set pattern of, I think, about 26 postures, and all the Bikram Yoga classes are kind of similar. And there is Hot Yoga, which is a popular practice in Western world, where they increase the temperature of the room where the people practice yoga asanas, right? So these are a few of the popular types of yoga. Now let us see what can help us. So how do you choose which yoga I should practice, right? How do you choose? So let me give you four parameters. The first parameter is dynamic practice, where you keep moving. The second parameter, which is the opposite of dynamic, is static. Okay, नो योगा इज अबाउट स्पिरिचुअलिटी, राइट? सो लेट अस राइट स्पिरिचुअलिटी हियर. एंड सिंस वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट आसनास और पोश्चर्स, वी ऑल आर टॉकिंग अबाउट फिजिकल फिटनेस. सो लेट अस राइट फिटनेस हियर. एंड लेट्स कंपेयर दीज प्रैक्टिसेस ऑन दीज पैरामीटर्स, राइट? सो इफ द प्रैक्टिस इज static, stationary holds, the where you hold the posture, the alignment has to be perfect and it is meant for physical fitness, then Iyengar. So if you are looking for something like that, then you can practice Iyengar yoga. Okay, then if you like dynamic movements, not really holds but one posture leading into another and then you know so on, then you can do Ashtanga Vinyasa and even Bikram Yoga, right? So it comes somewhere here. So if you are looking for dynamic practice where you take one asana into another, it's a flow, then you can practice Ashtanga Vinyasa, Bikram or Acro Yoga, right? So Acro Yoga, so that is about physical fitness and dynamic practice both. If you are talking about dynamic practice for which the aim is spirituality, then it is Kundalini Yoga. Okay, and static practice with spirituality as the aim, then it will be Shivananda Yoga. We did not talk about these even earlier because as I said, to answer this question, I have assumed that when people ask me about which yoga should they practice, they are necessarily thinking about physical fitness. And having said that, any type of yoga that you practice, it is bound to give you those mental benefits and slowly you are going to lead towards the path of spirituality, which is the ultimate aim of Raja Yoga. So though I have talked about these parts like Iyengar, Ashtanga Vinyasa, Bikram, Acro, you all need to understand that what you all are practicing is Hatha Yoga, right? So if you choose Hatha Yoga, it is going to give you those physical benefits, right? So instead of thinking about what practice I should do, think about how consistently I can practice whatever method of yoga I have chosen. I hope I was able to answer your question and I will see you in the next episode with another question about yoga. Till then, namaste.